Michaela's 3 years old at birth. She had lack of oxygen, and so she has intractable epilepsy. We started down the road of the pharmaceuticals to try to get her seizures under control, and we just weren't having a lot of success. For a while, you know, she was having 100 plus seizures a day. All in all, she's been on a total of 7 pharmaceuticals. The doctors had told us we were pretty much running out of options. There was a night we had seen promotion on TV about a documentary, and on the promotion it had a little girl that was having 300 plus seizures in a week, and she tried cannabis oil. She essentially got her seizures under control. In that same time, I knew there was a possibility for work that I was going to be relocated. We knew that if we ever got the chance, we wanted to try cannabis oil for Michaela. It gave us some hope, you know. And shortly after the documentary, we found out we were coming to Denver, Colorado. Once we got in Colorado, we went and got her medicine. Her particular strain is Charlotte's Web. Majority of the time, specifically with epilepsy, it's a high CBD strain with a little bit of THC in there. And so we give it to her 3 times a day, and we administer it through a syringe, through a little feeding tube. And that first day, we saw her seizures go from anywhere from 40 to 60 that we could see in a day. After she did her first dose of cannabis oil, that next day we saw anywhere from 0 to 5, 0 to 10 in a day. So we had a couple weeks of completely seizure-free days. We've also seen some cognitive improvement. We'll come in a room and start talking to her, and she turns her head and looks at us. Her grip with her hands is, in my opinion, it's a much tighter grip. She seems to have a little bit better control with her arms and her legs. Some of the benzodiazepines and meds that you use to control seizures, cognitively they slow them down to where they don't do much of anything. And so when you start to take some of that away, you see your kids improve. So we don't know if it was cannabis oil, or you don't know if it was the pharmaceuticals. But that being said, the cannabis oil has allowed us to decrease the pharmaceuticals. So right now we're on very small amount of 2 pharmaceuticals. We've been able to wean one completely. We've done a lot legislatively back in Illinois to try to get the process moving along, get the bill passed. And so now we know we're going to be able to go back to Illinois as a family and not be split up. So that means so much, and we are extremely grateful to the governor.
Yeah.
So yeah, a lot of times, especially people that are uneducated, you hear the word cannabis and you're given a child oil, cannabis oil, you think, this is crazy. Why would you ever consider doing that to your child? And you know, the kids that are going to be getting the oil, they have debilitating conditions. In Michaela's case and many of these kids' cases, they're running out of options. They don't have a whole lot of options. Now that I know and now that she's been on it, I haven't seen anything negative. I think there's still going to be educating to be done. That's never going to stop, because there is the negative stigma. There's so many families that we've been in contact in Illinois that are just hoping and waiting for this opportunity.
Okay.
The main thing is quality in life. She can be comfortable, and when she's doing good, when she's happy, when she's smiling, and we're not in the hospital, it means everything. And so that's all I can ever hope for Michaela.